Eddie Sutton Show, brought to you by Farm Fresh. You can almost taste the sunshine and the good things from Farm Fresh. And by Southwest Airlines, offering everyday low fares and convenient flights to many exciting destinations.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Eddie Sutton Show. I'm Dean Blevins, along with Oklahoma State head basketball coach Eddie Sutton. And pretty good start, coach. Ranked number 8 nationally, 6-0. Couldn't have started better, in fact.
We're off to a great start. You can't improve on the record. You can't improve on the quality of play. In fact, in our last outing with the University of New Orleans, we didn't play as well as we did in winning the NIT when we defeated Pittsburgh, Georgia Tech, Evansville, and Purdue. But this ball club, if they continue to work like they have been doing, they are going to get better, and maybe in time we will deserve the high ranking we have at the present time. But we are overranked at the present time.
Well, you have gotten the early recognition, I think, with the NIT success. That probably has a lot to do with it. Have you refocused? Have you set new goals because of the fast start?
No, I don't think so. Our goal was to win the NIT, and I say we. I'm talking about the seniors. I meet with them every year, and they felt like that was a realistic goal. And, of course, all of these preseason games as far as the Big 8 play, they're to prepare us for Big 8 competition. And we haven't had any cupcakes. All the teams we've played are legitimate ball clubs, and we are getting good experience there. And our next goal probably will be in trying to win the Big 8, which we've been pegged to win, but a lot of tough competition. The Big 8 last year was voted the toughest basketball conference in America. I think it'll be just as tough this year. A lot of quality ball clubs, probably more balanced, Dean, than we even saw last year.
Coach, let's introduce our viewers to the 91-92 Cowboy basketball team, and we'll take a look at highlights of the club so far, starting with the big guy in the center, Bryant Reeves, a freshman.
Biggest surprise on our ball club, number 50. Here you see good putback. When he arrived here, we thought we would redshirt him, and he just continues to get better and better. He's going to be inconsistent for a while, as all rookies are, but he is 7 foot tall, got marvelous hands, has had some good nights. The other evening against New Orleans wasn't one of his better ones.
Derwin Alexander, no rookie.
No, he's not. Very, very good scorer. Complete basketball player. Has really improved on his defense. There's a good shot of our wild student body. They've been excellent. They've done a great job with playing the part of the sixth man. But Derwin, number 14, a senior, gives us good leadership.
Next up, Corey Williams. What a player.
The best athlete probably on our ball club, marvelous speed from baseline to baseline, good defender, just a complete basketball player. Corey, Derwin, and Sean together form one of the best backcourts in college basketball.
Your son Sean on an offensive tear.
Well, Sean has gotten off to a fast start. He's second in scoring on the ball club behind Byron Houston. His strength, however, is in leadership and also his ability to pass the basketball. I think he has 36 assists and only 6 or 7 turnovers, great ratio.
Byron Houston.
He's the man. He's All-American in preseason, was the NIT MVP, has improved a great deal on his perimeter shooting. We're going to take a look at that a little bit later, but Byron Houston is an All-American.
Cornell Hatcher, All-American defensively for sure.
Well, they call him the Phantom, and he leads our ball club in steals, has remarkable instincts off the basketball. He's a good defender on the ball, but off the ball, he's the best that I've ever coached.
A junior, Randy Davis, next up.
Randy Davis is an outstanding athlete, needs to get a little stronger, good pass there, nice catch, goes to the floor, and a little turnaround jump hook. Good floor speed, good jumping ability, potentially a good shot blocker. As he learns the system, should become a very good player. And he and Bryant Reeves, a big question mark on this ball club, how quickly they develop and are able to feel that pivot position.
Last up, Milt Brown.
Milt Brown, the hardest worker we've seen in camp this year, made that decision. I'm coming back, I'm going to make this ball club. And every day you'll see him down there on his own working out. And his hard work has paid off.
And Coach, that's 8 quality players, but you have some other players I know you're proud of.
Well, those 8 players have been playing the most in the 6 games, but we have 4 other players, 2 freshmen and 2 junior college players, Sean Walker and Binky Tripler, the junior college players, and we have Terry Collins and Sean Pell, two freshmen, that I think any one of those four can and step up and start giving us valuable playing time. And then we have Mike Philpott, a walk-on from last year, Brooks Thompson, Earl Jones, Scott Sutton, Vaughn Bennett, and Jason Turk, five red shirts who really help our ball club in practice every day. So a larger squad than we had a year ago, and I like this team, Dean. I really believe if they continue to work like they have thus far, we've got a chance to be very good by the time we get to Big 8 play.
And we'll have a chance to catch up with the Cowboys and their triumph in the NIT tournament when we come back after this commercial break. Stay with us. And welcome back to the Eddie Sutton Show. Eddie's Cowboys started off in grand fashion in an impressive NIT tournament. Let's take a look at some of the action starting off in Gallagher-Iba Arena on national television.
To play basketball.
You bet it is, and the networks loved it, and your club loved it, starting the season against Evansville.
As I said earlier, all the teams that we've played thus far, with the exception of Tennessee State, have been teams that you may see in the big show at the end of the year in the NCAA tournament. Evansville's young, but a nice ball club, well-coached team. We won this ball game 86-57, but the game was much closer than that. There's a good play by Bryant Reeves. He was one of five Cowboys in double figures. He had 16, and Byron had 16. Derwin had 13, and Cornell and Randy Davis had 10 apiece.
Of course, the announcers were talking a lot about Reeves playing in front of such a large number of fans, number one, and very vocal coming out of Gans. How was that?
Well, they played that all the way to New York City. I think all of the commentators had a lot of fun. Here's a young man who from a hometown, I think about 350 people, and he said there are three buildings, a post office, a school, and I'm not sure what the other one is. But he comes into Gallagher Hall, plays on national television, but played very well. And then when he got to New York, his first road trip playing in Madison Square Garden. So he's come a long ways in a very short period of time.
This guy's come a long ways, but he started from pretty far down the road. Byron Houston started off sensationally, Eddie.
Well, he is one of the top basketball players we have in the college game, and he's improved in so many ways other than his scoring and rebounding. He's a much better passer, and unlike so many great stars, he plays both ends of the floor. He can defend. This is with Purdue, and this was a game that was played with a lot of intensity. Nice pass by Sean off to Randy Davis on the fast break. Gene Cady was my assistant for 4 years at the University of Arkansas and has built a great program at Purdue, and you would have thought this game was a conference game or an NCAA game because of the electricity that was in the air. Both teams just played as hard as they possibly can play. We won this game 67-48, but again, it was a much closer game than that. In all of our games we played thus far, we've shot over 50%, and the thing is, one of the games for us, not only good shooting, but also good defense. All of the teams that we played are shooting right at 40% from the field.
Yeah, I was going to say your defense is what has carried your teams throughout the years, and certainly those first two ball games you saw steal there, that carried you past Katie's group.
Well, defense is the backbone of our program. If we're going to be successful, we've got to play the good D.
Byron Houston has become a three-point scorer, shooting over 50% from three-point range. We will see him knock down a few trays coming up here in a few minutes.
Well, he has developed his outside shot. He's worked hard on it. I think he's 8 out of 17 for the season, so he is our leading three-point shooter.
And let's go to New York City. Madison Square Garden, in fact, OSU in the NIT semifinals. First game here, Coach, is against Pittsburgh, a nationally ranked team.
There's a three. A good three-point shot by Byron coming off a screen. He's doing a better job shooting the ball because he's squaring up to the basket much better. But again, a good lesson for young people. If you work hard, you get better, and he has worked hard on his perimeter shooting.
Key to this ball game, Coach, and winning it.
Well, again, it was defense. There's a good pass by Sean to Randy Davis. Repeat play of what we saw earlier. We had to shut off their inside game, and we did that. I thought our big people did an outstanding job of just keeping the ball away from them. And that's the best way to stop an inside game. Don't let them catch the ball.
Well, and you've got to love the fact that you go on national television to start the year and end up winning all of them and get to have your team go play in Madison Square Garden.
Well,
doesn't hurt your recruiting efforts, does it?
No, that's what Rob Evans and Bill Self, my two full-time assistants, they thought that would really help us in recruiting. We've had a great recruiting class this fall, but we certainly could use a couple more players. Good transition basketball. Nice driving layup by Corey Williams.
Cowboys rolling against Pittsburgh, and after winning this ball game, it's setting up a showdown with Georgia Tech and Bobby Crimmins' club year in, year out. It's a good one, but here in this Pittsburgh game, just fundamentally sound, Coach.
Great backdoor play. Anytime you get an overplay on the wing and you have the ball in the position where we had it and you backdoor, that's going to break the defense down. Here we're showing what we call secondary break, where we drag our fifth man down the floor and come up and back screen him. And it was a high lob pass by Sean to Byron. He dunked the ball. Another good defensive play by Cornell. Off to Sean, off to Darwin. One of the things that makes this ball club very good, very unselfish. Good shot of our team physician, Dr. Cooper, there on the bench. Another defensive play by Cornell Williams. We forced our six opponents into a lot of turnovers, and we've been able to convert a lot of those for easy baskets.
Sandwiched in between these NIT games was a win against Tennessee State here in Stillwater, but the Cowboys starting off the season in perfect fashion, and I know that the club enjoyed that. And then after this ball game, Coach, you come back home, and you have a chance to, as we see Byron Houston scoring here, he was the MVP of the tournament.
Well, he was outstanding, especially in the game with Pittsburgh. He just did everything, and he had everyone in the garden talking about his play. Good driving layup by Sean. That's one thing that's helped his game offensively this year. I think he's driving and penetrating much better than he did a year ago. He's much stronger. Leroy Yost, our strength coach, has really helped Sean along with all of his teammates in getting stronger. That was a big play in that ball game because Georgia Tech made a run at us about that time. Great driving layup by Byron. It showed his athletic ability as he laid the ball backhanded up off the glass.
And Byron doesn't hurt his All-American chances by performing so well in front of the New York media.
Well, that's for sure. And, you know, we've beaten a team from the Big Ten, a team from the Big East, and a team from the ACC. Three conferences that the last few years have been considered some of the elite conferences in college basketball.
And to get our viewers caught up to date with Oklahoma State, last game was against New Orleans, and it was a nail-biter in Gallagher-Iba Arena. Coach, tell us about this one. Goes to OT.
We're having difficulty with anybody that has big people inside right now, and they had two big guys that just wore us out on the boards. We had a chance to put this game away in the first half. We had an 11 or 12 point lead late with about 2 or 3 minutes to go. Missed a free throw, got careless with the basketball, turned it over, and you have to give their ball club some credit. They fought back, and instead of going at halftime with a lead of double figures, we got in at 30 to 25, and they came out the second half, and they were fired up, and it was just a dogfight all the way. Our defense kept us in this ball game. We shot the ball well, but we turned the ball over 20 times, and also we were beaten severely on the board. So that's what allowed this game to be so close. There's a great penetrating dribble by Darwin Alexander. The defense was forced to help, and Byron came in and slammed it home.
19 straight at Gallagher-Iba Arena, and I know you attribute a lot of that success to the very vocal crowd, game in, game out.
Our student body's outstanding, and they've got the adults even becoming much more active. And it is a tough place for the opponents to come in and play when you have a good ball club like we have.
So Oklahoma State 6-0, ranked number 8. We'll have Coach's Corner and Play of the Week coming back after this commercial break. Stay with us.
Play of the Week is brought to you by Southwest Airlines.
And this week's play of the week, Byron Houston, a three-pointer, Coach, against Pittsburgh.
The three-point shot is an area of offense that everyone needs to utilize as best they can. We're shooting about 10 or 12 three-pointers a game. We're shooting as a team 47%. Byron has led us in that area, 9 out of 17. And that is what is making him a very, very tough player to cover on the part of the other team, because everyone thinks he has to play inside, and that's not true. Now that he's been able to step out on the floor and shoot that perimeter shot, that will really add to his game.
Opponents and NBA scouts are taking notice of that, I'm sure. Coach's Corner coming up next. Stay with us. This week's topic, perimeter defense, Coach.
Well, the first thing in perimeter defense, you got to put pressure on the guy that has the basketball, but you must contain him. You got to try to keep the ball out of the pivot area. Now, freeze it right there. You can see Derwin has got the man with the basketball, good pressure. One pass away, we're contesting that. Keeping the ball out of the pivot area. Two passes away, you sink to the lane area and get in a help position. Our defense has allowed us to win six ball games, and if we're going to be successful this year, we've got to keep playing the good D.
Well, so far you certainly have, and you have played good defensively everywhere, certainly here on the perimeter and the big steal coming up.
Well, that's what happens when you put pressure on the basketball and you overplay one pass away. You're going to come up with a lot of steals.
We'll take a timeout. We'll come back with closing comments and look ahead to next week's schedule after this. And welcome back to the Eddie Sutton Show. Before we see you next week on this program, Coach, your team will have two games. It will have played a very big game coming up in Tulsa, where I know you have a big alum base against a good club in California.
We play the California Bears from Berkeley Saturday night in maybe arena over in Tulsa. And we do have a strong alumni base. Somebody asked me earlier this week, why are you playing that game away from campus? Two reasons. One, with all of our games being sold out in Gallagher-Iba, a great many of our fans will not have an opportunity to see us in person unless we take our team off campus. We're going to Tulsa this year to play California. We hope to be successful by having a big crowd over there and taking them over there again next year. And maybe in the future, we'll come down your way and play a game in Oklahoma City. But California is a very, very good basketball team. They have a young man by the name of Hendricks who's averaging 20 points and 12 rebounds, who plays in the pivot area. He's one of the best players on the West Coast. California will be a big challenge for us, Dean. And then, of course, we take our first official road trip going into somebody else's ballpark next Tuesday. We go down to Ruston, Louisiana to play Louisiana Tech. And last year we played one of our best ball games against Tech. We beat them soundly, and it's my understanding they are really waiting for us down there this year. So that'll be a tough game. And then we finish up a week from Saturday with Wichita State here in Gallagher-Iba, then take a week break for final exams, play Houston Baptist. So got a lot of tough games coming up.
Tickets do remain for that California ball game. 1-800-522-6858 is the number if you would like to pick up some tickets for that game. There's the number on your screen, 522-6858. And Coach, I know when you were at Arkansas, you had teams play at Fayetteville's the University of Arkansas, but they played in Pine Bluff and also in Little Rock. So this is nothing new to you.
No, this is nothing new. And like I said, I hope all of the people over in the Tulsa area in eastern Oklahoma will get over there and support our ball club Saturday night and have the same enthusiasm that our fans have had here on our campus in our first ball games this year. They've been tremendous. They've played the part of the sixth man.
Coach, you're off to a great start. Do you buy into the theory of peaking too early? Does it concern you, or are you one of those coaches that wants to play well from the beginning to the very end?
I think because basketball season is a long one, you're going to go through periods of time where you hit a plateau and you don't get any better. But our goal is to continually try to improve, try to get to the mountaintop, try to get this ball club ready for Big 8 play, and that'll be our next big goal. Go undefeated into Christmas. That's a goal that our seniors have, and get ready for the Big 8. And then if we do well there, be prepared to do well in the NCAA tournament. So we're going to try to win every ball game.
Nationally, Duke number one, strong club. What do you see on the horizon?
Parity in the college game is unlike we've ever seen it before, but I would certainly vote for Duke or North Carolina from what I have seen on television. Both those teams are legitimate national contenders, but there are a lot of other good ball clubs.
We appreciate you tuning in for this show of the first program of Eddie Sutton Show this year. And Coach, good to see you. Fantastic start. Keep it up, and we'll see you a week from today.
Okay, Dean.
For Eddie Sutton, I'm Dean Blevins. Thanks for watching the Eddie Sutton Show.